Good morning.
早上好。
Happy Brian's Day.
Happy Brian.
So cute of them.
双亲节蒙恩。
So good to see all of you here this morning.
今天早上很高兴看到大家。
My apologies, you know, the Bahasa, you will have to try to understand my English.
马来文部的哈，我知道你应该会明白英文啊。
Where to begin? I'm feeling a bit nervous today. I don't know why.
不懂从哪里开始，好像有点紧张哎。
We have all the board members' eyes looking at me, all the pastors' eyes all looking at me, and all the whole church's eyes all looking at me.
因为执委望着我，牧师们望着我，整个教会都看着我。
And today, thank God, I'm not looking just at me. Also, we've heard as well. As well.
还好我们还是一起伙伴呢。
And it so happens that you know both of us, our initials is PCL.
刚好我们的名字都是 PCL 的。
Yeah, I'm Pastor Kelvin Lee, so PCL. She is Pastor Cheryl Lai, PCL.
Pastor Kelvin Lee, 牧师，Pastor Cheryl Lai, 我本身。
Yeah, I'm so glad to see a lot of you here this morning, and let me just pray so that God will just calm my nerves.
让我先来祷告，好让神能够安稳我的心。
Father, I just thank you, Lord, for this morning.
阿爸天父，今早我感谢你。
We acknowledge your presence here, Lord.
我们知道你与我们同在。
And Lord, we look to you.
我们仰望你。
For your word, O God, this morning.
让你的话语来向我们说话。
We pray that, Lord, you anoint those words.
主啊，你恩膏你的话语。
That you touch lives today.
来触摸这里的生命。
It shall accomplish your purpose and your will for us today.
来完成你在我们生命的旨意。
Use us, Lord, even to preach your word.
使用我们来述说你的话。
Anoint our lips, O God.
恩膏我们的口。
As we submit to you.
让我们向你委身。
In Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣名字祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
There was a story of three young men.
这里有三个男生的故事。
Who were waiting outside the delivery ward of the hospital.
他们在医院的那个生产房里面啊，外面站着。
Yeah, waiting for their wives to deliver their babies.
等候着他们的妻子生孩子。
After a while, a nurse came out of the delivery ward and spoke to the first man and said, Congratulations, your wife has just delivered and she has delivered a pair of twins.
然后有一个护士出来说，他向第一个男生说，哦，恭喜你的孩子为你生了双胞胎啊。
And so the man was excited and he said, Oh, this is so amazing. It so happened that I'm working at the Twin Towers of Petronas.
然后这个男生就说，哎呦，很好，因为我就是在双子塔做工的。
And after a few more minutes, the nurse came up and spoke to the second man.
然后另外一个护士来了。
Congratulations, your wife has delivered a set of triplets.
他说，哎呦，恭喜你，你的太太为你生了三胞胎啊。
Wow, this is amazing. I happen to work for 3M.
男生说，哎呦，这么刚巧，我是在 3M 公司上班的。
And upon hearing that, the third man fainted.
然后第三个男生倒下来了，昏了。
So the nurse came and woke him up and said, Hey, sir, what's wrong?
护士就问，哎呦，这位爸爸什么事情啊？
I work for 7-Eleven.
我为 7-Eleven 做工的。
Thank God he didn't say 99 speed mark.
他没有说99那一个的 speed mark 哈。
Oh, anyway, having children is not easy, amen.
生育孩子真的不容易。
And it's even more challenging to parent them.
要培育他们更加不容易。
Today is Mother's Day.
今天是母亲节。
But of course, we are using this occasion to celebrate Parents' Day.
我们也用今天来庆祝双亲节。
And this is in honor of all the mothers and also fathers that who are here today.
是要尊荣在场的爸爸妈妈们。
So blessed Parents' Day.
双亲节蒙恩。
And we are parents, but we are also children.
我们是父母，我们也是孩子。
And so, children, it's important for you to honor your parents.
孩子们，我们要尊荣我们的父母，这是非常重要的。
And the basis of what we are talking about today, this morning, is taken from Exodus 20.
今天呢，我们所要分享的是来自出埃及记二十章十二节。
For Exodus 20 verse 12 says very clearly, honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you.
十二节有说呢，当孝敬父母时，你的日子在耶和华你神所赐你的地上得以长久。
You know, I want you to realize that this is a very important commandment in the Bible.
这是在圣经里头非常重要的一个诫命。
Exodus 20 gives us the 10 commandments.
出埃及记二十章给了我们十诫。
And this commandment happens to be the number 5.
而刚才我们所读的那一诫命呢，是第五个诫命。
So it's not just some teaching tucked away somewhere in the Bible, you know, but this is very major.
它不是要，不是在圣经里头藏在某一处的经文，这是非常重要的诫命。
So this morning I stand before you to reflect on a very important and one of the most significant command in the Bible.
所以我今天站在你们的面前，要与大家一起来反思这个非常重要的诫命。
And my message to you this morning is honoring our parents.
今天我要跟你分享的就是要当孝敬父母。
So let's go into the scripture and begin to look at the scripture and say what does the scripture says, you know, the profound significance of honoring our parents.
让我们今天向圣经里面探讨什么叫做当孝敬父母呢？
And there is also a blessing that comes along with it.
孝敬父母也会带来福分的。
So let's look at the commandment.
让我们来看这个诫命。
When God gave us this commandment, honor your father and mother.
当神给我们这个诫命，就是当孝敬父母的时候。
Essentially, it's telling us that there is a divine order that has been a form created by God, and that's the family.
那就是神给我们的圣旨是关于家庭的。
This is in line with God's order for the family.
就是神呢创立了这个家庭的这个秩
序。When we talk about family, family is God's idea, God's plan.
家庭是神所设计的，是神的旨意。
And that parenthood, when we talk about being parent, that is patterned from the intimate relationship between God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
而为人父母的模式呢，其实是源自圣父、圣子、圣灵的亲密关系。
So that means when we look at parents, parents remind us of the better, purer, and more reliable love of God that made us.
所以当我们看到父母的时候，父母呢就向我们彰显了神的更好的、更纯洁的，而且更加能够依靠的爱。
Therefore, our relationship with our earthly parents is an illustration of our relationship with God, our Heavenly Father.
所以我们与地上父母的关系其实是展现了我们与天父的关系。
So this is God's divine order for the family, for parents and children.
所以其实就是神所设立的这一个的规矩。
Let's look at the word honor.
我们来看什么叫做孝敬。
What is honor?
什么是孝敬?
Of course, the word honor can mean to respect, to esteem, or to regard someone as important or valuable.
当然孝敬是关于尊敬啊，是关于敬仰啊，是关于看一个人为很尊重的。
You know, the Hebrew word for honor is kavad, which means heavy.
这个 honor 的这个的原文，孝敬的原文是卡瓦，其实有重、沉重的意思。
What does it mean to be heavy?
什么叫做沉重呢？
If you think about heavy, you talk about, you know, those precious metals, stones. The heavier they are, the more valuable they are.
可能就是那种金属啊，那些钻石啊，越重就越珍贵哦。
So when it comes to about honoring parents,Heavy is not about your parents' weight.
当然，当个孝敬父母，不是说在说父母的重量啊，哈，那个身体的重量。
But it's about when how you regard them. You regard your parents as very valuable.
而是你如何的去珍惜你的父母。
Very important.
非常重要。
That you esteem them greater and more important than even yourself.
你敬仰他们，把他们看为比你本身更重要。
Is that what's happening, you know, in our families?
这就是在我们家中应该发生的。
I'm a Chinese.
我是个华人。
But I don't know Chinese.
但我不懂中文。
Shame. Yeah, so they say what is a banana Chinese? Or something like that.
香蕉人。
But I'm going to bring to you a Chinese word.
但我要跟你介绍一个中文。
Okay, and this is the word on the screen. 笑。
Xiao.
If I just say xiao, 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 it's very funny if I just use that word only, right?
如果我一直做笑笑，好像是啥的意思啊？
啥还是
啥
crazy 啊？
癫狂。
So in Hokkien, you say xiao, are you?
福建话，你癫狂了，你傻了吗？
But of course, this is not that word. If you just say it that way, the word xiao.
这个笑
It's actually a combination of two letters.
来自两个文字.
It has two words. One, the word is 老.
第一个就是老.
老.
老.
And the second word is 子.
子.
子. All right? So, pronounced correctly. Okay, good. 老 means someone that's elderly. Like your parents.
老就是你的长辈，比你更年长的。
And the word 子 is basically referring to kids or to children.
子就是孩子的意思。
So the word 笑, 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 is when the word 老 is above the 子。
这个笑呢, 就是那个老字, 在子的这个字的上面哦。
So, who comes first?
所以谁为先?
Who is to be honored?
谁先被尊重?
Who is to be esteemed?
谁先被敬仰?
Whose preferences are to be on the higher agenda?
谁应该放在优先秩序的前头?
Who has priority?
谁是你先要照顾的?
The 老.
就是老.
And that is our elderly, our parents.
就是我们的长辈, 我们的父母.
You got it?
知道了吗?
So when you combine the two letters, the two words together, you have the word 笑.
所以两个字加起来, 就是笑. 不是华丽吗?
I don't know. 孝顺.
孝顺.
Maybe that sounds better. So when you look at this Chinese word, it's telling us two things.
两样事情.
First of all, we got to acknowledge their position.
第一, 我们就要承认他们的地位.
Our parents have been placed in a position for us children to look up to.
我们的父母呢, 是被放在那个的位置, 是要我们去敬仰他们的。
So we must always recognize their position in the family.
我们要常常看重他们在家里面的地位。
Now don't think that this is understood. Don't think that this is something that you should know.
别觉得这个是理所当然的有时候。
Because unfortunately in our society today, there are the children's behavior and treatment of parents clearly do not acknowledge their position in the family.
因为在我们的社会里头, 有时我们看到一些的孩子啊, 他们对待父母的态度与行为呢, 根本都不像这里所说的。
And unfortunately also, there are parents who upside down the two letters.
有时我们看到父母与孩子的身份是调转的。
This is their own doing.
这是父母本身的可能自己的作为。
Where the children are put into a higher position than the parents themselves.
父母把孩子放到更尊贵的地位，超过自己。
And when that happens, the whole divine order is upside down.
如果这样子做的话，神本来的旨意呢，就倒转了。
That is not God's plan.
这不是神的旨意。
That's not God's idea of a family.
不是神在设立家庭本来的构思。
So when we don't put our parents in that position, this amounts to failing to honor them.
如果我们没有把我们的父母放在应该有的位置，我们就没有孝敬他们了。
No matter whoever they have been and whatever they have done, it does not remove them from their position, from their low position.
无论父母做过了什么，都不能够动摇他们的地位，就是这个老。
You know, I remember my maternal grandmother, my mother's side, my mother's mother.
我记得我的外婆。
After my grandfather passed away,
我的外公去世了过后。
So she's become the matriarch of the family.
她就是家庭之主。
And my family, my mother's side, is quite a large family.
我的妈妈那儿是个大家庭。
So together all in, great grandsons, great grandchildren, all it probably about 80 plus of us.
把整个家族放在一起，大概有八十多人。
So every time when it comes, I remember, you know, every time Chinese New Year will come, she'll be the highlight, so-called the highlight of the whole celebration. She has that a whole attention, you know.
在农历新年的时候，大家聚集在一起的时候，我的外婆就成了焦点。
You know, when she comes down the stairs, you know.Yeah, all attention, you know, points to her.
当她从楼梯下来的时候，我们全部人都望着她。
So everyone, you know, just really will come around her because she's such a loving grandma, you know, a great grandma as well. So the position that she has in that family.
因为我们每一个人都敬畏她，都敬爱她，所以她在我们家族的地位是非常棒的。
And after she passed away.
他去世了过后
，The family still gathers.
家庭还是我们家族还会聚集在一起。
But then we have lost that central figure.
但是没有了那一个的焦点。
So you see, elderly, the elderly has a certain position. No matter what it is, you know, we must acknowledge their position.
所以我们家中的父母啊，是应该有他们的地位的。
Secondly, we got to respect their authority.
第二呢，就是要尊敬他们的权柄。
By virtue of their position in the family, parents have authority over their children.
因为他们是父母，所以很自然的，他们在孩子的生命里头就有权柄。
And it is required of us as children to respect their authority.
所以我们身为孩子的，就要尊敬他们的权柄。
No matter how old, how mature, how independent we become,God still says in Proverbs 23, verse 22, Listen to your father who gave you life, and do not despise your mother when she's old.
无论你有多老、多成熟、多独立也好，你都要依照箴言书，箴言23:22所说的，你要听从生你的父亲，你母亲老了，也不可藐视她。
If God has placed us under the authority, to rebel against that authority is to rebel against God Himself.
神把我们放在这一个的权柄之下，如果你反叛这个的权柄，你就是在反叛着上帝。
And it is in the family unit, the basic unit of society, that we learn about respecting authority.
我们是在家庭里面这个社会最基本的一个的单位里头，我们学习如何的尊敬权柄。
And I would say that those who have learned to respect authority in the family are more inclined to respect other authorities.
那个在家庭里面懂得如何尊敬权柄的，他们在社会上也知道如何的去做。
And you must remember all this, you know, that.As much as we will one day expect our children to respect our authority, we must do the same with our parents.
如果我们要孩子来尊敬我，我本身也要尊敬我的父母。
So these are the two things that is quite clear from, you know, this the word honor.
所以孝敬呢，在这里就是两个重点，是很清楚的。
So how to honor their sacrifices?
如何的
How to honor our parents, sorry.
如何的孝敬我们的父母呢
There are many ways, of course.
有很多的方式
But the heart of honoring our parents are these few things.
但是最主要的由心发出的就是这几项
First of all, is recognize their sacrifices.
第一就是要知道他们的牺牲
Our parents have made lots of sacrifices.
我们的父母呢，为我们付出了很多很多。
Some of which we may know of.
有些你是知道的。
some and many others perhaps we do not know.
但是其实很多你都不知道的。
I remember my eldest daughter.
我的长女。
She's looking at me now.
Where?
She's 24 now. You know, 24.
24岁。
Remember when after she was born, of course we have our first child, well, we were very excited.
因为她是我们的长女，所以当然她一出生的时候，我们非常非常的兴奋。
But we have a so-called an awakening to the reality of being parents.
那时我们突然醒觉，我们做了父母了。
It was not easy in the sense that, you know, she very hard to put her, I'm not supposed to say that, I mean, it's very hard for her to, not to put her to sleep, but to make her sleep, yeah.
很难让她睡觉。
You know, those days you have that, the, what do you call it, 摇摇啊。
我们有那个沙龙。
沙龙啊，沙龙啊。So that time, no automatic one,
don't have the, 那是没有自动式的。
So use hand one, right?
要用手。
Either use hand or use leg.
或者用脚。
So we've been doing that 1 hour plus, 2 hours.
一个小时，两个小时。
The moment you stop,
一停，他又哭了。
And then in the middle of the night, we will be sleeping. And she can, you know, and she wait until so late until she will sleep. Then we were so tired, we will sleep with her. All both of us were snoring, sleeping.
半夜的时候，我们哪弄到她睡，我们就开始睡着了。半夜。
And then all of a sudden,
又哭了。
哇！然后 her cry is really loud. She was both of us will be shocked, you know.
她的哭泣是很大声的，会吓坏我们的。
I'm sure many parents have experienced that before, right?
我相信很多父母都一样的遭遇。
But when that happens, it causes me to realize one thing that I still remember today.
但有一样事情我到今天还是记得的。
It's not easy to be parents.
做父母不容易。
You know, and I remember saying this, if ever in the, anyone who is not filial to the parents, that's one of the greatest sins.
我就说，谁不孝敬父母的，这个是真的是大罪啊。
It may be something simple, you know, just taking care of, but imagine the many other sacrifices your parents who have made for you.
只是弄他睡觉都那么辛苦了，你们可以想象还有更多的牺牲呢。
The task of parenting is not easy.
父母的职责真的不容易。
It can be painful.
可能有时是痛苦的。
It can be stressful.
压力的。
It can be expensive also.
也很昂贵的。
Yeah, say that again. It can be expensive.
昂贵的。
Sangat mahal. And, often unappreciated.
但很多时候没有被珍惜。
Children.
孩子们。
Once a year, Parents' Day, Mother's Day, Father's Day, you bring them to go and for makan. You think that's appreciation?
一年一度的母亲节、父亲节、双亲节，你觉得这个就是珍惜了吗？
It's not enough.
不足够。
There's more that we can do to appreciate our children. Amen.
Appreciate children.
It's parents.
我们还可以做更多来珍惜我们的父母。
That's the role of the interpreter to correct me when I'm wrong. So for a child to not recognize and be grateful for the sacrifices parents have made on his or her behalf is an insult to the position of authority and value that God has given to parents.
身为孩子，如果我们没有真正的去感激、珍惜我们的父母，是对上帝的一个的侮辱。
Secondly, provide care and support.
给予关怀与支持。
You know, there's a verse in 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 8 that says this.Anyone who does not provide for their relatives, and I would say use that word relatives for parents, yeah, and especially for their own household, has denied the faith and is worse than an unbeliever. Wow, strong statement.
提摩太前书五章八节有说，人若不看顾亲属，这里我放成是父母，就是背了真道，比不信的人还不好，不看顾自己家里的人更是如此。
So this verse is specifically for Christians.
这一句经文其实是给基督徒的。
Christians are saying that if you don't provide for your elderly, the relatives, those in your household, you are worse than an unbeliever.
这里说如果基督徒啊，我们连家里的长辈也不照顾，我们比不信的人更糟糕。
So it's telling us that our faith requires us to therefore recognize our parents' sacrifice, be grateful,But also back up with our actions.
我们的信仰要求我们要承认父母的牺牲，要感激父母的付出，而且要以行动来去展现出来。
The biblical commands and example that tells us that we should honor our parents into old age.
圣经告诉我们，我们要孝敬我们的父母，直到他们终老。
And not stop after we turn 21 or become independent or have your own families.
不是当我们组织了自己的家庭，我们独立了就停止的。
For honoring parents is a lifelong commitment.
孝敬父母是我们一生都需要做的尾声。
You know, in Singapore,
在新加坡
there is a law
有一个条例
that they enacted and it says a maintenance of parents.Act.
就是一个照顾父母的条例。
Basically, this allows Singapore residents who are aged 60 years and above,
就是新加坡的居民，如果他们60岁以上了，
if they are not able to provide for themselves,
不能够自己维持自己生活，
it allows them to claim maintenance from their children.
这个条例允许他们向他们的孩子索取生活费。
Who are capable of supporting them?
就是这些孩子，如果他们本身是有这一个的能力去支持父母的
，but not doing so，
但是不去做。
Can you imagine there's an act like that？
你可以想象为什么有这样子的一个条例呢
？When you need to enact such a law，
如果你需要设立这样子的一个条例
，it can only mean that there are too many cases of parental abandonment，
就是证明说有太多抛弃父母的这些的案件了。
I think at one time you were wondering whether Malaysia should come up with such a law or not.
可能马来西亚也曾经在想，需不需要有这样的条例呢？
You know, I hope Christians will remember God's command, which is simply to honor our parents, and that means to take care of them, especially in their old age.
所以我希望我们基督徒都能够保守神给我们的诫命，就是要孝敬我们的父母，直到他们终老。
And thirdly is,How do we honor our parents?
第三，如何孝敬父母呢？
Pray for them.
为他们祷告。
Pray for them.
为他们祷告。
Whether your parents are Christians or do not, or are not, they will be praying for you all the time.
其实无论你的爸爸妈妈是基督徒还是不是基督徒，他们都在为你祷告的。
Shouldn't we as children at any age do likewise for them in return?
我们身为孩子，不论你是什么样的年龄，我们不是应该也要为他们祷告吗？
The command in scripture is not time limited.
圣经给予我们的诫命是没有被时间所限制的。
Through our prayers, we demonstrate our love, our care, and our respect for the ones who have raised us.
透过我们的祷告，我们向我们的父母展现我们对他们的珍惜、感激与爱。
So these are just three things, you know, due to time. These three things that we can easily do, you know, to honor our parents.
刚才所讲的三样呢，是非常简单的，我们能够为父母做的。
There are many more things, of course.
当然还有很多很多的方式。
But when we come to this commandment, you talk about honoring parents.
当我们来到这个诫命，关于孝敬父母。
He also talk about the blessings of honoring our parents.
也说到当中的福分。
Exodus chapter 20, verse 12, the second part of it says, you know, that why should we honor our parents? Why honor your parents, your mother and your father, so that your days may be long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you.
出埃及记二十章十二节的后半部有告诉我们，当我们孝敬父母的时候，我们的日子在耶和华神所赐我们的地上就得以长久。
So to those who honor their parents, God promises a life of joy and security that others will not experience.
所以当我们孝敬父母，上帝是应许给我们喜乐的安稳的生命。
So if you honor your parents, God will generally speaking reward you with long life.
所以当我们孝敬父母，神应许说会让你长寿。
Of course, this promise does not override other decisions that sometimes we may make that impact how long we live.
当然，这个长寿的这个应许并不废除我们如何做了一些的人生的抉择。
But generally speaking, this is a promise that God gave to those who honor their parents.
但这是神给我们的一个的应许。
Now, notice that this is not only in the Old Testament that the promise was given.
这个应许呢，不只是在旧约里头哦。
But it's also given to the church today, even in the New Testament.
在新约里头也给现在的教会。
You see, Paul revives that commandment and the promise in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1 to 3.
保罗在以弗所书六章第一到第三节也有说
It says, Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise, that it may go well with you, and that you may live long in the land. So Paul repeats that commandment in the New Testament.
保罗在重申这一句话说，你们做儿女的要在主里听从父母，这是理所当然的，要孝敬父母使你得福，在世长寿，这是第一条带应许的诫命。
And so he can also carry that promise into the New Testament.
所以保罗呢，将这个从旧约的应许带到新约了。
That's the blessing of honoring your parents.
孝敬父母会带来福分。
And secondly, the blessing, another blessing is the divine favor that you will receive.
第二个福分就是神圣的恩宠啊。
When you honor your parents, Proverbs 23, verse 25 tells us that, May your father and mother rejoice, may she who gave you birth be joyful.
箴言二十三章二十五节说：“愿你的父母欢喜，愿那生你的母亲快乐。”
Will your parents rejoice over you?
你的父母会因你而喜乐吗？
Because you are honoring them.
因为你有在孝敬他们啊。
When you are honoring them, your parents are rejoicing.
当你孝敬父母，他们在喜乐的当中。
And when your parents are rejoicing, you will receive the divine favor.When God sees you honoring your parents.
当你的父母在喜乐的当中，你就会领受上帝的恩宠。
Unfortunately, there are many parents who lament because of what their children have done to them instead of honoring them.
但是我看到很多的父母都在哀叹因为孩子所做的。
Guess what God would do to such children?
你觉得神会如何对待这些孩子呢？
Divine favor or divine judgment?
神圣的恩宠还是愤怒？
Well, all that we need to do is remember this. Honor our parents.
我们需要做的就是孝敬父母。
And the favor of God will automatically comes along with it.
神的恩宠就会自然的流进去我们生命里头。
And I want to conclude.
来到总结。
Going back to my daughter.
又讲回我的女儿。
Okay, after this, I'm going home. She will, of course.
No food for you.
She will, huh? No food for me. I cook their food, on the.
开玩笑，开玩笑。
Yeah.You know, when just before she was due for birth,
当我的长女快要出生的时候
you know, we were very excited. You know? So he said that the rough delivery date is around December kind of thing.
我们当然很兴奋啊，因为大概是在十二月份。
So then we say, oh, how nice if she's born in 1st December.
哇，如果她在十二月一号出世，多么好呀！
Then after that, we realized that, hey, you go to a government hospital, they don't give you a date on. You know, you have to follow their date. I mean, you cannot simply choose your date. You got to follow their date.
但是因为是政府医院，所以我们不能够选择日子的，要让他们去选。
Maybe around 1 week or so, probably just then one day my wife realized, you know, why her urine so dark.
Before she was born.
Before delivery, yeah.
大概一个星期出生之前，我的太太就发现，哎，为什么我的尿液那么的深色呢？
You know, like teo color, you know.
好像那个茶 ，deo 啊，好像茶的颜色。
So we quickly went to the guy need to check it out.
我们就赶快去看医生了。
And they really realized that she has developed fatty liver.
Fatty liver. 就发现了原来太太的那个肝脏了有太多的脂油。
And then we were asked to quickly admit.
我们就赶快让她进院。
So admit the time, then the.The people were saying, you know, oh, wow. And then there is, okay, before going that, my wife has, during those days, she has arthritis on the hip.
Arthritis. 之前我的太太有 arthritis 风湿。
Joint pains.
那种风湿。
Hip joint
pains. 关节炎。
So she cannot deliver normally. She has to go by cesarean.
不能够自然的生产，需要开刀。
开刀。开刀。So, and the doctor say, if the condition remains, wow.
医生说，如果还是这样。
医生讲，哇。So if her condition remains, the problem is that, you know, her blood will not clot.
Will not clot.
Cannot clot, that means.
如果继续这样子的话，她的血液就不会凝固凝结。
And so if they go with the cesarean, then she may bleed and bleed and bleed.
如果开刀的话，可能会流血不止呀。
So we, you know, so they had to give her in vitamin K injections, I think. Yeah.
要给她维他命 K 的这个注那个打针
，you know to help, you know to be the clotting,
好让他的血能够凝固。
But anyway, cut a long story short, she admitted a few days before, you know, all this kind of thing, and then lo and behold, they decided to deliver the baby.
然后他就进院了，然后这个医院就决定为他接生了。
And right on 1st December,
就正正在十二月一号。
Alethea was born.
我的女儿 Alethea 就出生了。
And we thought this is over.
我们就以为啊 ，OK 了，就结束了。
But then after that, you know, when they were trying to, I mean, of course, sew up the wound and everything.
当他们为她去缝针的时候
，the baby was fine.
孩子 OK.
Very healthy.
健康。
But big size.
很大，体重很重。
Unfortunately, my wife's wound, you know, the cesarean where the wound not close.
但是所缝针的那个伤口呢，却不会愈合。
And she suffered an ordeal for almost a month in the hospital.
我的太太留在医院整个月呀。
They have to, sorry for those mothers who are about to.You know, who are pregnant, who are about to give birth. You know, they might scare you. I'm sorry about that.
如果当中现在怀孕着的，对不起啊，不是想吓你。
Testing. For the whole month, you know, they. Sorry. So they have to clean the wound, scrape, you know, and all that.To help the wound to close, so it almost a month of ordeal in the hospital.
受苦了整个月啊，因为又要洗伤口等等。
And I remember telling God one day, you know, I said, God, let all this come upon me instead of my wife.
我跟神说，神啊，让我来承受这些痛苦吧，不要让我的太太承受。
So painful to see her going through all that.
因为我看到她这么的辛苦，我心里面很痛。
And that's why we came up with our daughter's name, the Chinese name.
所以我的女儿的华语名字呢
Chinese name is 李诗恩。
李诗恩。
诗 is the like 诗歌啊。
诗歌啊，嗯，诗歌的诗。
So, so, N is of course grace 啊。
嗯，恩典就是恩典，恩就是恩典。
So we say her life will always be a reflection, will be a song of God's grace.
嗯，因为我女儿的生命呢，就是让我们看见神的恩典。
Now, why am I telling you this story?
为什么要告诉你这个故事？
Essentially, is to say, you know, the parents.In all your own ways, you have gone through, you know, the challenges, big challenges.
Because 每一个的父母呢，都会经历很多很多的挑战。
And we just want to honor you.
我们今天就是要尊荣你。
For what you have gone through.
因为你所经历的一切。
But we know that God's grace will always be upon you.
但是我们知道神的恩典一定会覆庇你。
Because if God has called you to be parents,
因为神让你成了父母，
His grace will be upon you.
他的恩典就会来到你的身上。
And so, perhaps some of us, myself included,
可能我们的当中包括我，
we have not honored.Our parents or honor them enough.
我们没有足够的去孝敬我们的父母。
And therefore, this time is a call for confession and repentance before God.
所以在这个时候，是一个能够在神的面前去承认，也求神宽恕的时候。
That if God were to tell us about honoring our parents and then we go off today and then not do anything about it, you know, that would be a really, really a tragedy.
如果今天我们听了神的话语，但是我们没有实行出来，那么就不好了。
And then this morning as I was worshiping, and then what a great worship time, by the way. And God just spoke to me and said, I know time is catching up, but...God just spoke to me and said that there are parents here who are really burdened. Burdened.
刚才在敬拜的时候，我体会到神告诉我说，这里当中有一些的父母是背着很重的担子。
Parenthood has not been easy for you.
为人父母真的不容易。
It may not have been a joy for you too.
可能不是你的喜乐在某一个时刻。
Or there are parents here also because you have been burdened for your children.
这里当中有可能有些父母在为孩子忧虑。
Either they have not come to know Christ.
可能孩子还没有认识耶稣。
Or they have gone wayward.
或者孩子离开了上帝。
And you are very sad and sorrowful about it.
你非常的伤心与难过。
And God just told me, say,Pray for this.
神告诉我说要为这些父母祷告。
I know it's supposed to be a celebration, a joyful kind of thing, but I sense that God is more important to God, you know, to minister to these parents.
我知道今天是喜庆的日子，但是更重要的是让上帝来服侍这些的父母。
There are some parents also here.
这里当中可能也有一些父母或许。Testing.
What am I trying to say? Yeah, there are parents who think that you have made a lot of mistakes.
当中也可能一些父母犯了很多的错。
And you cannot forgive yourself.
你本身也不能宽恕自己。
But God says, you know, come to Him.
但是神说，来到我的面前吧。
Just release that to Him.
将一切交托给神吧。
God will minister to you.
神会服侍你。
So shall we stand at this moment?
让我们一起站起来。